Good evening, this is Ash, and welcome to another model train review video. Tonight, I thought, as this is the fifth video in the mini December Diesel series, I thought I'd take a moment to rewind 6 years through the hands of time to early 2006 when Hornby first released their all brand new model of the very successful Class 60. And this is one of the trio that made their debut in early 2006. Hence the others being 60026 in the EW and S livery and 60078 in the mainline blue livery. So, without further ado, let's have a look at some of the features. Let's start off with the packaging, as on this side of the sleeve, as you can see, the reference number is R2489, Loadhaul CO-CO diesel electric class 60 locomotive, and this one is numbered as 60007. Which, in my theory, I nicknamed this as the James Bond train, hence being 007. But more on that another time. Meanwhile, sticking with the model, there is one thing I do like about the original outer sleeves, is that on the back, there is a brief history on the prototype, complete with a photograph of 60007, hauling some, I believe, clay wagons. So, let's open up the box and let's see what you get inside. Just as expected, there is a fair amount of meat on this fine model. All nicely packed between the two divisible styrene trays. You do get a decoder sleeve, so if you use some of the older uninsulated decoders, you may use this to insulate your decoder if you wish to use this model on DCC. So, just like with the other Class 60s, by removing the two outer plastic clips or lugs, whichever you prefer to call them, please excuse my sleeve. First block in the view, and as you may see, my example of 60007 has been modified with a Fox transfer EWS Beastie, which applied to the real thing from 2006 to around 2008 when it went into storage. But meanwhile, sticking with the model, let's remove the front screen. Just like with all the other Class 60s I've covered, you do get some instructions which tells you how to care and maintain your locomotive, as well as pictograms on how to change the air dams. Also remove one of the NEM couplers if you wish to use the solid air dam in place of the cut out one if you wish to add some of the brake pipes and the screw link couplers, but I will cover that in more detail a little later. But likewise, this side tells you which parts that need to be lubricated on a regular basis, and also how to unclip the body from the chassis if necessary to carry out necessary maintenance. Well, that's all there is for the paperwork. So, I think it's time to crack on with the unboxing. I have placed the NEM coupler, which I will use to hook up to the brand new test train that made its debut with 60091, of which 60007 will be used to haul the test train. So, by removing the top partition, and underneath this, what I call tracing paper, we now have a full view, or almost a full view, of the beast. 60007 in the Loadhaul livery, which, my example, has been modified with the EWS Beasties. So, being very careful here not to damage the horns, as they are very, very fragile, just by carefully pulling the model from the tray. And it does look like I've got the tissue paper with it. Just place that out of the way. Here is the model. Nice amount of meat, got see-through grills. And if I just place it onto the track, and tilt the camera forwards, just like with the other Class 6s, this one also has opening doors, although these ones are a little stiff as they've not been opened much. And please excuse the fingers, sprung butters. The original price of this model when it first came out, the recommended retail price was £89.99. And you do get an awful lot of detail for your money. So just dragging the camera and panning along the sides, I thought it would be time to do some close-ups. Just like with the real thing, the exhaust pod and the top grills and all the rivets appear to be there. So Hornby have done a great deal of effort with this now 6 year old model, and you can also see the horns and the buffers on the rear cab from this view. And unlike the older Lima model, this model also has etched footsteps as well. The handrails are separately fitted, but sadly these are chrome painted plastic rather than metal, but nonetheless it's still an excellent model which gets top marks from me. The warning signs and the fuel gauge on the fuel tanks and the compressor, which can just be seen beneath the EWS logo. And as we pan our way to the first truck, or bogie, there is some impressive amount of detail on these as well. One thing you may have noticed on my review of 6099, the footsteps on this model have now been painted white, which does improve the model further from when this one first made its debut in 2006. Also, to the left of the driver's cab door, there is the locomotive data panel and the fleet number of 60007. And also, if I just put the camera into the right position, I'll see if I can try and get an inside cab view for you as well. Just as expected, and if we just go into 3x zoom, you might just be able to see the driver's controls, which have also been nicely picked out, such as the regulator, the AWS bell, the signaller telephone, and also the gauges and the speedometer and the ammeter. All nicely picked out on this model, and this comes as standard on all issues of the Hornby Class 60. So, I just thought I would cover this for a change, as this is often a feature that I've not covered in previous Hornby Class 60 reviews. So, just zooming out to normal zoom, I think it's now time for the test drive. So, I'll just return the camera to its default position, which will be here. I shall stop the video now, whilst I assemble the coupler. But before I do, there is something I did forget to mention that I promised I would have mentioned, and that's the accessories. In this rather worn out sachet now, due to the age, there is a set of air dams, brake pipes, and a spare NEM coupler in the sachet that can also be used as well. Right, I believe that's all there is to cover for this video. I shall stop it for now and assemble the NEM coupler, and I will be back in a moment with a test drive. Just like with all other recent review videos, I shall do various angles to keep the video interesting. So I will be back in a moment, stay tuned. Welcome back, and now that I've set up the model of 60007 with the NEM coupler, it's now time to commence with the test drive. As you may see on the screen, I've had to do some slight temporary modifications to the test track, as the couplers on the wagons, for some reason, keep breaking. So, hopefully, there shouldn't be any coupler breaks this time, but without further ado, let's commence with the test drive. Currently going up to 30% power. As you can see, very smooth running at a relatively low speed, although this model has been stored unused for around 2 years now, so it will need a running and a warm up. And as with 60091, 60007 is also hauling 8 Backman BP TEA 100 ton crude oil tankers, all of which do have the narrow NEM couplers, which are only just passable on these R609 curve track. Just going up to around 35 to 40% power, the model is starting to improve with response as the motor is warming up. But just like with the other Hornby Class 60 variants that I've covered in the past, this one is as smooth as silk and is a very, very powerful hauler. I may consider getting some more TEA tankers in the same livery to make a 12 car or a 12 wagon train, which should give it more weight to haul in future review videos of other variants of the Class 60s that are released by Hornby. Also, for those of you that have been subscribed to me for a few years now, may recognise this model from my earlier videos that I used when I filmed it with my digital camera. So, this is a brand new review and test run of this model that I've had for a very long time, and also it's in high definition as well. Just to keep the video interesting and varied, I shall allow 2 more passes from this direction, and then I shall switch the camera around just to give more angle views. As you may hear on your speakers or headphones, whichever you are using to listen to the sound, you may notice there is a slight whine from the bearings. So that tells me that this model is due for a lubrication very soon. But apart from that, it is very, very silent. And also, there is barely any noise coming from the motor either. Like with the past review that I've done of 6091, I do apologise if there's any blurring from the LED lights. This is due to the power of these lights on the Class 60, which should make nighttime operations quite fun as well as daytime. Excuse me. After this one, I shall allow two more passes, and then I shall change the camera angle again, just to keep the video interesting and varied. As with the headlights, the tail lights are also nicely illuminated as well. Which, in my opinion, these are the very spectacular effects or features from this model during nighttime running as well as daytime running. And I'm sure you will agree that this model of 60007 in the Loadhaul EWS livery does match the Backman TEA 100 ton tankers perfectly. Although I would like to see Backman release some VTG and EWS and possibly even some Freightliner branded TEA 100 ton tankers as well in their future range. Now that the model has warmed up a little bit, I shall increase the power to around 40 to 45%. Just to warm up the gearing and the driveline a little bit more. Although, as a protocol, I never really run model trains at more than 50% power if they've not been ran for a long time, as I do not wish to risk damaging the gearing or the driveline or overworking the motor. Right, just to keep this video interesting, I shall allow two more passes after this one, and then I shall switch 60007 to the other end of the train to work the test train in reverse. I tend to do this with all of my videos from now on, as I like to cover both the offside and the near side of these model trains, just to show off the details to any potential buyer. Just like with 60091, it's now time for 60007 to haul the train in reverse with aim to show more of the offside of the locomotive as opposed to the near side in the earlier clips. So, without further ado, let's turn up the power and let's zoom out whilst keeping in line with the locomotive. I'm keeping my fingers crossed that there shouldn't be any coupler breaks, but if there is, I will have to may have to swiftly stop the video to rectify this. Right, I shall allow two more passes and then I shall stop the camera and film from another angle just to keep the video interesting and varied. Just to let you know, I do intend getting the updated DB Schenker model of 60007 when Hornby release the model, which should be now in their 2013 range. So a review of that model will ensue as soon as I get round to purchasing it once it's released. As you may notice in the background, there is a model of 60 062, and the Princess Coronation City of Leeds Class 8P Stania locomotive. This will be reviewed in a future video, which will be part of my new 2013 videos to come in January. But likewise, sticking with this video, I shall allow two more passes, and then I shall move the camera to its final position, where it will be time to bring this review and test run of 60007 in the Loadhaul and EWS livery on my variant to a close. I shall allow two more passes, and then I believe it will be time to bring this review and test drive of the Hornby Class 60, which is the 2006 model of 60007 in the Loadhaul EWS livery, which is based on my modified version, to a close. Well, that concludes my review and test run, or test drive, of the 2006 Hornby Class 60 in the Loadhaul livery, numbered as 60007, to a close. My final score for this model, as you'd expect, I'm going to give this a perfect 10 out of 10. I do hope that Hornby will consider adding working directional cab lights to their future Class 60 models, as well as add lining to the pipes on the bulges, as well as paint the brake disc yellow, as that would really make it an absolute stunner of a model. But in my opinion, it still deserves a 10 out of 10, and that concludes my review. If you have any comments or questions, please feel free to post them in the comment section below, and thank you for watching. Have a good week, and stay tuned for another video coming soon.